the matches are a bit tougher for Shami than they are for Waldner in the Swedish league, or what would you say, Tekken, there?
Yeah, and also it's interesting because this was the final pair in the last Legends Tour in Belgium, where J.O. win against Jami. So I think Jami is trying to get his revenge, like he said yesterday on the press conference. So this is an interesting, very interesting game. Mm-hmm. They have played each other so many times, and they know each other so well. And I talked with J.O. after his first match against Jiang that it's little more difficult to play against a penholder pimple player than it is to play a backside player, because mm-hmm. you're more used to play such a player. So I think also J.O. can raise his game in this match also, and I think he needs it, because Jami is, for me, the favorite of the tournament.
Mm-hmm. And they also played the finals in the European Championships in 1994, where Jami won after playing a very, very good game, I remember.
Yeah, and like we said about Filou, in a period he was maybe the best one, or one of the two, three best players in the world. And mm-hmm. that was the same with Jean Michel Saive, 93, 94, 95. He mm-hmm. was ranked number one in the world, and winning the Europeans and losing in the final to Jean-Philippe Gatien, 93 in the World Championship. So
Gothenburg.
These years, these three players, Filou, Jami and J.O. was dominating table tennis in the world.
Correct me if I'm wrong, but I have a small feeling that Jami was a bit of a small nightmare for you during those years.
Yeah.
Where he beat him in Gothenburg in the semifinals, right? Or was it the quarterfinals?
Jami beat J.O. in the semifinals.
Exactly, and then 93. He beat him in the finals in the European Championships.
Yeah, that was, I mean, he was, like we said before, dominating, and many times we discussed in Sweden among the players and coaches mm-hmm. how to beat Jami. Because mm-hmm. he was the best player in that period.
Didn't have that many problems like many others on the serves, and Waldner's serves.
He
aggressive, and just played topspin on almost all of them. Yeah, like this, yeah.
He has always been very impressive in his receives, and, mm-hmm. and especially top spinning and half long ball,
mm-hmm.
playing on the half long ball with forehand. He was and he still is very strong. So that means that he can many times start the rallies of the game and get attacking in the attacking position. So this is. His strongest point, I think.
Mm-hmm. Doesn't really play that hard. Not a really hard hitter, but a very aggressive forehand anyway. So. Waldner's trying to get in position to play his forehand, but the receives are very good so far from Shami, and he's leading now 5-3, 6-3. Mm-hmm. 7-3 for Shami, and Waldner looks a little bit confused. Long fast serve. One more time there. He was trying to get in position to play his forehand, but the receive was too deep down to Waldner's backhand, so he missed the ball.
Very good shot by Jami. He gets a difficult receive against him, but still can play good forehand mm-hmm. In a difficult direction. So Jay was surprised.
9-5, and Sav is two points away from. Oh! Looks a bit bothered by his groin, Waldner, there, actually. Not moving really well, I think.
He was trying to play short,
mm-hmm.
short ball, but Tommy played it more wide than he thought.
Mm-hmm. Four set points now for Jean Michel Saive for the first set. 11-6, Jean Michel Saive wins the first set against John Ove Waldner in the semifinals in 2015 ITTF Legends Tour. For viewers who just joined us, we can say that we have one finalist ready, and that is Jörgen Persson. And he's waiting to get his opponent from the match between John Ove Waldner and Jean Michel Saive.
Jomi is a very safe player. He's playing many balls on the table, moving good,
mm-hmm.
and is capable to play many balls on the table. And it doesn't suit J.O. that good. He wants to play more short rallies.
He really needs to find out a solution here, because otherwise I think it will be a difficult game for him to win. Jomi is looking really confident and moving very well. Oh, he missed that one.
Start to miss two serves in this set.
Mm-hmm.
Two serves in this set, so not a good start.
Oh. Strong forehand there. Waldner didn't reach it. 3-0.
You can see that Chami, like we said before the match, is looking for revenge.
Mm-hmm.
Very focused and doesn't let J.O. play or give him the chance to come into the game. If the serve is a little too high, he's there. He's very good to attack over the table.
5-1. Oh. Very nice forehand down the line by Waldner there, and gets him two points against Saive's 5. Still needs to pump up a bit more to really, really be in the game. 5-3.
Three quick points for J.O. here. Important to get some energy back.
He's getting better positions for his forehand now. And maybe that's because he's moving a bit better. I don't know. What are you saying?
Yeah, moving and also serving a little better.
Mm-hmm.
That Jomi cannot attack now. And J.O. is the first one who attacks.
All. Waldner talking a bit there with Yang Jiliang on the bench. Maybe he got some good advice there. Seven six there after that small error by Waldner. Misjudged the ball. And it hit the net. Oh, very nice serve.
Very good straight serve.
Mm-hmm.
Pushing Jomi away from the table. And the spectator is feeling that J.O. is back in the game.
probably they are waiting for the dream final, if we can call it that, here in Sweden. Jürgen against Waldner, but as we said, Jean-Mi is looking out for revenge, so it will be really, really tough for Waldner. Especially if he doesn't win the second set. 8-0.
Jean-Mi not happy with that forehand mistake.
Mm-hmm.
The key point here.
Nine eight. Waldner now looking more a bit more and more pumped up. Ooh, there he had to move.
Very good block by Jean-Mi.
Very smart play.
Straight and far out to JS forehand. And the serve, Jean-Mi has the serve.
9-9. Ooh. Missed that last backhand shot there. Very nice game.
He's going for it with the backhand, but
oh, 10-0. Waldner missed the ball there. Yeah. 11-10, a first set point to save in this set. Very nice receive there by Waldner.
Yeah. Short. More out to the forehand.
The crowd is cheering. Ooh. Good serve gave him this, gave him a set point. 12-11. Very nice. Oh, very nice by Saive.
Some difficult balls in the rally in the beginning, but still Jean-Mi coming back to getting the point.
Oh, 13-12, Saive in the lead.
Jo is pushing very hard with the serve now, and Jean-Mi is not controlling it, but getting edge ball and the set point.
Very nice receive. Flick down to the middle of the table and
very flat.
Yeah, very flat. Flat flick, so and surprise caught Jean-Mi very, very hard. Ooh. Good defense there by Waldner, even though the serve was long and Jean-Mi made a good attack. Oh, Waldner wins, and you can see that he was very, very relieved by getting that second set, and 1-1 now.
Very impressive game by Jo in the end of this set. We have talked about it before, but I really felt in this set that if you lose this one,
it would be difficult for him to come back. Yeah,
because physically, Jo is not in the same shape as Jean-Mi, and as longer as the game moves on, it will be more difficult for Jo.
Yeah, will that be an issue, you think?
Yeah.
So I think if it gets to five sets, it will be hard for Waldner to win.
Yeah, I think so. But still, also Jo is smart the smartest player ever.
Yeah.
So he's smart, and I think he will not go into too many rallies. He will try to serve very
and
good.
Kill the ball
and
there.
And try to be aggressive on the first points. We will see.
Third set, 1-1. Jean Michel Saive to serve. Waldner takes his forehand. Oh!
Fantastic.
Very nice by Saive.
It's a lot of spin in that ball, in that smash. And Jean-Mi is handling it perfectly and getting the point.
In Swedish, we say that he made a punched a hole in the air. Missed the ball completely. Probably something with a bounce there. Three-zero, Jean-Michel Saive.
Jo is playing, starting this set very good. He's getting three good possibilities to win the points, but missing all three, so.
One. Oops, racket goes up in the air and missed the forehand down the line. Four two. Waldner is to serve now. Jean-Mi leads 4-2. Very nice serve. Caught Jean-Mi off guard. And then he missed the forehand again. He's not really happy with his attacks right now.
He's serving very well now, Jo. He's getting the opportunity to attack almost every time. And getting some points also on his serve.
But still, Jean-Michel Saive is in the lead, 6-3 in the third set here in the second semi-final of the 2015 ITTF Legends Tour. 6-4.
Jo is trying to flick a lot on Jean-Mi's service and serves and not playing too many short receives, and I think it's a good tactic.
This is interesting because the forehand flick hasn't been Waldner's strength during the past years, or should I say in the years before. Now he's up to 6-6, 6-6, 6-all. The game feels totally open right now.
Yeah, he is playing very well now.
And also looking quite... He's moving very nice, I think.
He's focused, but he's very relaxed also, talking with the spectators like this. And I think it's nice. Nice for the atmosphere, for the...
Yeah. Oh, very nice shot there by Sean Foran. Spin back, Gio's top spin. Spin it back.
Jamie has always been very strong in attacking, like... attacking on the top spin, top spinning back the top spin.
Yeah, top
you can say
back
like that.
Yeah, top spinning that top spin.
Yeah, and there's not many easy mistakes he makes there. But very tight.
It was very early with that kind of with that stroke spinning, playing top spin on the opponent's top spin.
Yeah,
now everyone's doing
that.
Everybody's doing that, but he was one of the first.
Yeah, that's correct.
Eight all.
Here comes the backhand serve.
Yeah, first one this tournament from Mr. Saive.
Back and serve again.
9-8 save. Good receive by Waldner. And there he hit the edge of the racket. Two set points for Jean Michel Saive, 10-8. And Jean Michel Saive wins the third set and now leads 2-1. 11-8.
JO is a little frustrated here in the
third game, yeah.
After the third game. Playing well, I think playing very well. Getting the chances, but unfortunately
has some errors there,
error,
I think,
yeah,
with,
yeah.
With his forehand, which
errors
confused him and made him a bit frustrated. So we'll see if he can correct that to stay in the game.
Och det är så att vi såg att du sa det också till mig här, hornen kommer ut nu på spelarna. Det betyder då att de är riktigt taggade också.
Ja, jag tycker det i alla fall. Det är så.
We have now former world champion in team, Erik Lind, getting interviewed by Michael Anderson and talks now about that the players here are very, very focused, even though the morning practice and yesterday's practice was a lot of fun and joke and they didn't seem that focused, but it's been a very, very big difference now today. You can see that in his eyes, and Waldner's also got the characteristic red cheeks, which means he's really, really focused. Waldner's playing around with the spectators here. One. Two one, Waldner. Very nice point.
Deo feels that if he leaves the table, it's very difficult in the long rally, so he comes more up, more close to the table, playing more close and
tries
more hard.
Tries to kill the ball.
Yeah,
one more time,
giving Jommy less time to play, and that's a good tactic, I think.
For one, really aggressive now. Ooh. Try with the backhand block down the line, which was also one of his trademarks during his prime.
Yeah.
But that stroke is not really that easy nowadays with a new ball, with the plastic ball.
Difficult stroke, the shorter way of the table, and also with the plastic ball now. But you can see now that Gio is playing more aggressive. More aggressive.
Ah, wonderfully played.
Trying to play hard the first two, three balls, pushing Jommy away from the table.
Yeah. Six-two, Waldner leads in the fourth set here in the semifinal in the 2015 ITTF Legends Tour. 6-3 now against Jean Michel Saive from Belgium. Seven-three. He's now found the forehand positions a lot better in this set, I think. So
yeah. Serving very well, you know, quick service, long, and or a different variation of the short service with different spin.
But also feels that Jean-Mi is leaving the table a bit more this set.
But
so
he feels that his receives is not good enough.
Mm-hmm.
That makes him leave the table.
Mm-hmm. 7-5. Waldner said to the spectator that he is in total control of the game. We'll see about that if if we are looking forward to a fifth set here. Right, 8-5. Must say that he is surprising me a bit because he's looking more and more sharp and moving better and better. Not the opposite,
no,
which I was expecting.
And it's still some unforced errors which you are not used to see by Yeo.
Mm-hmm.
So he's leading, but still he's not happy.
Ooh, that point can be very, very important, I think. So
comes the timeout.
It's 7. Yeah, takes the timeout here. None of the players have a coach here.
No.
Oh.
No coach. But
and the crowd is cheering now for you. We'll see what he can do about that with the support of the Halmstad supporters. Halmstad, who will be the host city for the World Championships in 2018. And most likely the smallest city that ever hosted a tournament of that size. Ooh. Well, there it was again, the unforced error with the forehand.
Blocking very good,
mm-hmm,
pressing
and then missing the final.
Missing the forehand.
The final forehand.
Again.
Exactly the same point, almost. 8-9. Save is now only 2 points away from the match. So
of course, it's very impressive by Jean-Mi to catch these hard blocks from
Yeo. Yeah, very nice. Moves perfectly here. Now again. So it was 3 forehands in a row that he missed. It was very good opportunities for him.
Yeah.
So now Jean Michel Saive has got 2 match points.
The flick again.
Very nice flick.
Into the body in the middle of the table.
Very effective.
I think Jean-Mi is going for the backhand serve.
Oh. Would you say that he's nervous when he missed that serve, or was it just
it's a critical
pure unluck?
Critical situation of the game.
Mm-hmm. Got big problems with just exactly that ball when he starts with the first bit slower topspin and then Saive goes out and just fishes the ball.
Yeah, and but clever fishing, mm-hmm, because he's putting the ball in a position though you have to move.
One more match point, Jean Michel Saive, 11-10. And the match is over. We have the winner, Jean Michel Saive, beats Jean-Ove Waldner 3-1. And will now face Jürgen Persson in the finals.
Yeah, and
can we say that this will be the match, the final between the two best players?
Yeah, probably today.
Today, of course, today.